Welcome to the Science Movie Club, where we go through movies that bring up scientific ideas. Today, we're looking at the movie Hidden Figures. It's a movie about the space race and mathematics, but it's also a unique window into how the definition of the word computer changed during the 20th century. Oh, and of course, spoiler alert. If you ask someone in the first half of the 20th century, what is a computer? They would say it's a job. There are doctors, there are lawyers, and there's computers. It was a job that was usually occupied by women who did math within a set of rules, like calculating interest rates for banks or rocket trajectories for NASA. In 1957, the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics, aka the Russians, launched the first satellite ever named Sputnik 1 into space, and thus began a rivalry with the United States, aka the Americans. The American agency, known as the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, or NASA, began the Mercury Project, whose goal was to launch a man into space, ideally before the Russians. The Russians would end up sending a man there first, but the men who would eventually go to space on the Mercury Project, known as the Mercury 7, set the example for future astronauts in their image as well as the mathematics and engineering that went into their launches. Let's take just a moment to focus on the main character, Katherine Johnson. In case you didn't believe me that a computer was a job, well, here's a compilation to prove my point.
Not many computers last more than a few days. He's been through a dozen in as many months.
Excuse me, ma'am. Mr. Harrison's computer reporting.
Take the desk in the back. I'll get you working it.
Ruth, what's the status on that computer?
She's right behind you, Mr. Harrison.
Computers don't author reports.
Mary, a person with engineer's mind should be an engineer. You can't be a computer the rest of your life.
I have told you this. Computers don't author reports. Fix it.
Those are my calculations. My name should be on it.
That is not the way this works.
Long story short, we no longer need a computer in this department. Progress is a double-edged sword.
Get those trajectory calcs worked out. We need them for the Redstone test.
In fact, Johnson's character arc in the movie is that she was more than just a computer, and that she was instrumental in finding the hidden figures, or calculations, that were needed to make sure the space capsule landed on a specific location on Earth so it can be picked up and rescued. One of the major challenges NASA faced was how gravity would pull on a space capsule as it flies through space. The force of gravity will be directly related to distance, meaning, as a space capsule gets nearer to the Earth, the gravitational force in the capsule will increase. The movie shows Johnson and the rest of the team at NASA using Euler's method, which makes for a great plot device, but the math that was actually used is much richer than just one method. But all of this is just to make a point, that computers were humans who did math. But human computers like Katherine Johnson were about to be replaced by electric machines. In 1911, several companies that were inventing machines for everyday use, like commercial scales and time cards, merged into one company. And in 1924, it was renamed the International Business Machines. Their main machine, the IBM, could do high-level mathematics, like calculating census data or money from Social Security, and analytic geometry for rocket trajectories. IBM contracted for NASA, and their main machines developed early versions of real-time communications. During the Mercury Project, IBM could receive thousands of bits of information per second. For more about bits and information, check out our video about Claude Shannon. The IBM was able to accept all this information in real time and decide which program needed to be addressed in order to continue, which would give Mission Control the information that they needed. For more about machine thinking, check out our video about Alan Turing. While the IBM computer was being installed at NASA, the math was still being done by human computers, including Dorothy Vaughan. Vaughan was born in 1910 in Missouri and graduated from Wilberforce University at age 19 with an awarded degree in mathematics. She moved with her husband to Virginia and in 1943 began her career at Langley Research Center, where the movie takes place. She worked in the West Computing Group, which segregated black female computers who would calculate flight paths for NASA. The team at IBM also had a part in developing the math behind the hidden figures, which determined spacecraft trajectory and re-entry points by building the machine seen in the movie, the IBM 7090 transistorized computer. This was good for NASA, but not great news for the human computers.
I was wondering if you know what they're building over in the tech wing.
It's called an IBM, a mainframe machine. Apparently, it can do our calculations in a fraction of the time.
I guess that's good for NASA.
Vaughan realized that at some point, humans would have to push the computer's buttons, and that humans would eventually transition from computers to programmers.
Line of what you do.
It's not gonna matter soon. This IBM's gonna put us all out of work.
What can we do about it?
Only one thing to do. Learn all we can, make ourselves valuable. Somewhere down the line, a human being's gonna have to push the buttons.
That's right.
Vaughan's foresight was that she would have to learn how to communicate or program these machines. And the language in which to talk to the IBM 7090 was Fortran. Debuting in 1957, Fortran, from the words formula translation, was a big development in computer programming. Previous programs had to be in binary code or other difficult languages, but with the creation of this higher-level language, it allowed the inclusion of engineers and mathematicians.
The computer uses it as its high-speed storage unit and information holding device. You have a brain.
The IBM was able to process commands that were input with a series of punch cards. On a punch card, every column was another character, and once the card was punched, it stored information. Each card typically stored one line of code, and so a program required a stack of these cards. As the machine reads the information, it inputs it into its memory, and after executing the program, it would print an output.
Bill, we've got numbers.
What kind of numbers? What's your name again?
Dorothy Vaughan.
Dorothy Vaughan.
Vaughan's understanding that human computers were about to become obsolete contributed to her becoming an expert at computer programming, even helping the IBM guys to get the machine running. She also understood that the IBM would require a team, and so she trained the still human computers in the segregated department programming languages and concepts.
The IBM 7090 data processing system. It has the capability of solving over 24,000 multiplications per second.
Holy Moses, that's lightning fast.
They'll never get that to work.
No, it'll run eventually. And when it does, we have to know how to program it. Unless you'd rather be out of a job.
No.
And then she brought her trained team with her to the IBM. Cue the victory march.
Temporarily, yes. We need the IBM for Glenn's launch. The lead engineer says you're good with the cards, programming, and such.
What about the girls here?
Well, human computers can't calculate an orbital flight in the time we have. They'll stay put for now.
What about after now?
After Glenn's launch, NASA's dissolving the computing groups.
I'm not accepting reassignment unless I bring my ladies with me.
Excuse me?
We're gonna need a lot of manpower to program that beast. I can't do it alone. My gals are ready. They can do the work. Ladies, we've been reassigned. Leave your calculators. You won't need them where we're going.
The end of human computers was a difficult transition, but it was some consolation that race would begin to play a smaller role in the industry. For example, Dorothy Vaughan was the first black woman to supervise a department at NASA. The technology shown in the movie has progressed from giant computers to PCs and smartphones, but punch cards were being used until very recently in events like voting. And the IBM 7090 set the stage for other mainframe computers like the cloud, which we use all the time today on our internet devices. So, if you learned something that you didn't know in this video, be sure to let me know what that was by leaving a comment down below and let me know which movie